Hello everyone and welcome to another anatomy video. Today we will talk about the anatomy of the spleen of the dog and we will talk also about the blood supply to the spleen. So let's get started. The spleen, as described before, is located more on the left side, start dorsally there. With the head of the spleen here, and after that moves ventrally, and it follows somehow the greater curvature of the stomach. If you follow this, this is the greater curvature, so it leads on the greater curvature of the stomach. The spleen is fixed in its position by the greater omentum and by the ligament extends between the spleen to the stomach, the gastrosplenic ligament, this ligament here. The spleen in carnivores is tongue forming, like as you can see here, it's like a tongue shaped. It's very important to mention that if you have like a ventrodorsal, like a X-ray, in this case, you will find the spleen over, the two parts of the spleen on each other, like on the left side. If you have a lateral X-ray, you will find that spleen extends from the dorsal up to the ventral part of the body. And we will talk about this once we move to the X-ray pictures. The spleen is supplied by what's called the splenic artery. The splenic artery is a branch of the celiac artery, which we are going to dissect later. This is the celiac artery here. It gives three main arteries, the hepatic artery, the left gastric artery, and the splenic artery. Splenic artery moves to the spleen, supply the spleen, and gives another branch to the stomach called the left gastroepiploic artery. So we will talk about this later too. The hilus of the spleen is very long and extends overall the visceral surface of the spleen. Here you can see the hilus, where you can find in this case in the dog, comparing to ruminants for example, that the arteries coming from the splenic artery enters the spleen at several levels, and that's why it's a little bit difficult here to remove the spleen. And it's not difficult, but in this case, remember please not to cut or to suture the splenic artery from the beginning, because the splenic artery gives arteries to the spleen and finally it moves toward the greater curvature to the stomach. So if you cut it from there, you cut the blood supply to the stomach, and this way we have to cut the small arteries here at the hilus level to be able to remove the spleen in some clinical cases. So what we've done, actually, we removed the greater omentum completely, and we removed, the connective tissue of the gastrosplenic ligament to show you the blood supply to the stomach, to the liver, to the spleen, and other organs inside the abdominal cavity. The blood supply comes directly from the abdominal aorta there, dorsally inside the abdominal cavity. We can see the aorta. This is the aorta. This is the caudal vena cava. So from the aorta, the first big branch comes inside the abdominal cavity, the celiac artery. So this is the celiac artery. It's a big one here. The celiac artery gives three main branches. One to the liver, one to the stomach, and one to the spleen. The splenic artery, as you can see here, so this is the splenic artery again. It comes at this level here. It gives a lot of branches to the spleen. Let me just put it this way. This is the splenic artery under my finger. It gives a lot of branches to the spleen, as you can see. At the same time, it moves along the hilus of the spleen like this and gives a lot of small branches to the stomach called the short gastric arteries. And that's why, guys, in carnivores, we are not allowed to suture if we want to remove the spleen, for example. We are not allowed to cut or to close or to suture the splenic artery directly here, because if you do this, you stop the blood supply to this part of the stomach completely. And what we have to do in this case, yes, you have to do exactly as I've done here. You have to close and suture these small arteries toward the spleen, but not the splenic artery itself and not the short gastric arteries. So this is very important. Yes, you have to close a lot, sometimes 12, sometimes more small arteries here, one by one, and after that you can remove the spleen. And in this case, we will keep the blood supply to the blood supply to the stomach. Yeah. Otherwise, if you cut the main splenic artery, this part of the stomach will die, you know, after a few hours after the operation.